This is Anders Pond, and what's cool about this area is that it is a natural tupelo pond.
Biologist Lori Lomas is looking for an animal few folks ever get to see. She's scanning the trees of this tupelo swamp for the threatened Rafinesque's big-eared bat.
Being that the Rafinesque big-eared bat is a species that depends upon older growth trees, you tend to find them here. This tupelo tree was discovered about 4 years ago. We put some radio tracking devices on the bats to figure out where they were going in the winter. Turns out this is the tree where we would find them almost all the time. In the winter, these bats will all colonize together in the same roost. However, in the spring, the males go their separate ways, where the females all stick together and they form a maternity colony where they'll all have their pups in their summer roosts.
One maternity colony has found the perfect summer home in this rather spooky-looking structure.
This house was abandoned 18 years ago. We were going to tear it down. We decided that we would rather keep it open for the bats and actually keep the house in working order enough so that they can use it as a roost. Oh, there's some right there. One, two, three. You typically find the bats in abandoned houses in the spring to summer months because they're looking for a warm roost. And we have some towers as well that were built specifically for these bats in this maternity colony. And they're close by, and the bats will readily move from here to the towers depending on the temperature. I can hear them. They're in there. Oh, there's one right there. The Rafinesque big-eared bat has very large ears. As you can tell, they kind of resemble rabbit ears. They're used for echolocation. They're used for navigating in the dark and also for hunting prey and also for communication with each other as well.
With man-made roosts and with further protection of pristine habitats, there is hope that the Rafinesque's big-eared bat may one day be out of the woods.
What we know about this bat is that it was in decline. Because these guys need old bottomland hardwood forest, very old forest. We've purchased this refuge. We're continuing to purchase more properties and let the properties get older and older and older. And as the trees mature, that will create more habitat for these guys.